Cinematic colors are something so much people strive for when creating their look for their videos or just color grading in general. But they sometimes don't know how they should push their image from point A to point B. So they try to use LUTs as often as possible, but this will definitely not result in a satisfying image whatsoever. So in this video, we will build a look from scratch that is often related to cinematic, and you can find that look in some of the most popular movies out there like Joker, Blade Runner, and Tenet. So with that being said, let's just start to build out our notary. Okay guys, so first of all, I don't want you to get too scared or too overwhelmed with this look because it's actually pretty simple. The way we're achieving this teal and orange look is not by crazy layer mixers or parallel mixers, even though we now know what they are and how we should use them because of my most recent video, but instead we're just using 9 basic serial notes, and 3 of them aren't even necessary. They are nice to haves, but they are not needed at all. Let's just start out and build our notary, and once I'm labeling everything, it should all make sense to you, okay? So don't freak out just yet. So let's just create 9 basic serial notes, just like this, and put one on top and put note number 8 and 9 on the bottom, because those are the 3 notes that aren't necessary at all. Note number 2 to 4, they are necessary, very necessary, as well as note number 5 to 7. Okay, now so let's just start labeling them so you know what I'm talking about. So the first note is always noise reduction, at least for me. As I said, you don't need that. And note number 8 is going to be our glow, and note number 9 is going to be our grain. Okay, so these are the 3 notes that aren't even necessary. What we should focus on is note number 2 to note number 7, because this is just where the look's happening. So let's keep going. Note number 2 is going to be our highlights. Note number 3 is going to be our balance. Note number 4 is going to be our exposure or primaries. So note number 5 is going to be our log wheels. Note number 6 is going to be the teal and orange look. And note number 7 is just a simple look adjustment if we need that. So let's just start out in our primaries wheels. So what I want to do first is open up my scopes, my parade, so I get a basic idea of where the image is lying, if anything is clipping, or if the shadows or blacks are crushed. But as I just see right now, nothing's clipping, nothing's crushed, so we have room to work. Now what I want to do is bring my offset just a little bit up, and then adjust the contrast. Something like that is looking pretty good to me as of right now. And then what I want to do is bring up the saturation just a bit. And now we see, if we take a look at the scopes, the blue is pretty dominant, and green and red aren't that dominant. And we don't only see that by looking at our scopes, but we also see that by looking at the image right there. As you see, there is a lot of blue in my image. And what I want to do is go to my balance and balance this shot just a bit. So what you can do is just adjust the temp and tint slider right there. Maybe something like that is looking pretty good. And then we can go under our log wheels, because let's just take a look at the highlights and bring down the reds to a point right there, and then bring down the greens as well. So everything is nice and even right now. Now, the next step is actually to go into my teal and orange node, node number 6, and start creating the look. Now, the way that we create this look is by using our primaries. And first of all, we gotta put some teal into our shadows. Something like that is looking pretty good to me right now. But as you can see, we got a lot of blue everywhere in the image, but as well in my skin tones. So I'm not doing any scientific stuff right there. I'm just gonna eyeball this. So I wanna counter my skin tones to get them look nice and even by using my gamma, and just bring back some orange. Maybe something like that. or maybe just a little bit more. Okay, so that's looking pretty good. And as you can see right now, we still got some teal in our shadows left, but we can exaggerate this even more by just pulling in way more teal and then adjust our gamma accordingly. Let me focus on the skin tones once again. As I said, this is nothing scientific. This is just me eyeballing the skin tones, which should work fine, something like that. Okay, and now if you take a look at the black points or the blacks in the image, okay, let's take a look at my cap right there. Take a look at this jacket behind and this black chart. If you take a closer look, there is some crazy blue going on in my blacks, and I don't want that. So we gotta counter that by going into our log correction, node number 5, changing from primaries wheels to log wheels. And what I want to do then is go under my shadow and counter this blue by bringing in some red. Okay, and now just take a look at the blacks in this jacket or in the cap. Even some slight adjustments like this. Let me deactivate this node so you get to see the before, and then reactivate it. Now you see the after. Okay, so take a look at all those shadows right there, all those black points. They are pretty blue. And now if I activate them, they get a nice, a very better color. Okay, so what I want to do now is actually go back to my teal and orange look and bring some teal back in the shadows. Let's go really crazy, something like that. And then counter to my skin tones. Now it's looking pretty good. So then we gotta go back to the log wheels and do the adjustments in our log wheels once again to counter this. Something like that should look pretty good. Yeah, that is solid. And now just take a look at the skin tones once again and go under your midtones on the log node in your log wheels and bring in some orange, okay, to really make them skin tones pop. Now this is looking pretty good, and this is basically pretty much done. Okay, we can go there and get our blacks really black if we want so, or we can adjust the low range. So something like that should look pretty good. And then let's maybe pull in some orange once again. So now something like that is looking pretty good to me. Now we hit Shift F so we can see this in a little bigger screen. This is looking very good as of right now. Now what I want to do is I want to make the image pop a little bit more to give it some more contrast. Now we can do this by our editable splines or in our lift gamma gain. And the way I like to do it is with the custom curves and the editable splines. So in the top right corner of those curves, you see these three dots. Just click them and then select editable splines. Now select this dot in the top right corner and bring this up ever so slightly. Okay, so we got some more juice in our image, just a little bit. And now click this dot in the bottom left corner to adjust our shadows, and then make this smaller and just bring this down. Okay, you see where we're going? Okay, we can make this even crazier, something like this, if you want to. Okay, let's make it something like that. So you really get the teal and orange look from a movie. And maybe let's now adjust our skin tones just a little bit more, because I feel like they are still a little bit off. And then go midtones. Let's give them some more juice. Okay, so this is looking pretty good. Now, what I want you to do next is you can add this glow if you want to. Let me just show you how to do it. Go under node number 8 and add this glow node. Just add some subtle glow effects to the image. And what this does is it preserves our lamp in the background from clipping. So we can pull down the shine threshold. Okay, don't freak out, this is looking horrible. Now change the composite type from add to soft light. And now things start to look a little bit better. And then bring up the shine threshold just a little bit, maybe something like that. And then adjust the spread to get some nicer highlight roll-offs. Okay, something like this is looking pretty good. Now we can increase the shine threshold to brighten up the image just a little bit. And now this is looking very, very good. Now, if you want to, you can add some grain, but as I said, you don't have to. Let's just deactivate that, as well as the noise reduction. And this is also for all of you who are using DaVinci Resolve, the free version, because you won't be able to use noise reduction or film grain. Now, with the glow being added, let's go to our highlights, node number 2, and let's close this effects library. And in my highlights, as I said, we don't want to do any crazy keying or whatever. So just turn off hue and saturation. And under luminance, give it some low soft, maybe around 15, and then bring up this part. Okay, but right now, if I bring this up all the way, whatsoever, I'm not seeing anything, and that is because we have to hit this magic wand or hit Shift and H on your keyboard. This will activate it. As you know, I like to use keyboard shortcuts. So yeah, bring this up so we just select our highlights, the brightest part of the image. And then what I want to do is go under my highlight slider, hit Shift H again so we turn this off. And then bring this down ever so slightly, just like this. It's looking pretty good to me. Now, with that being done, you could also add some film grain if you want to. Let's go under effects and then type in grain. Now I'm going to use my favorite grain, which is the 35mm 400T, and bring down the texture quite a bit, and then open up the grain size as well as the grain strength, something just like that, and then bring the global blend down to blend it all in nicely. All right, and with all those steps done, you see there is not a lot going on. And as I said in the beginning, you could also get away with just using those 6 nodes, because this is where the look is happening, this is where all the balancing happening, and the look and the look adjustment. But you could, if you want to, add some glow and grain, and this would be the final result, guys. So guys, that's a wrap. I hope you enjoyed today's video. If so, please consider leaving a like and a subscribe if you haven't already, to not miss out on any upcoming content in the future, but also to help me spread out this video to even more people that might be interested in that specific topic. So with that being said, thank you all for watching. Hope you all have a great day. See you in the next one. Bye.